a lot about the stewardship of creation that is in Scripture that I don't see being honored by the administration right now.
It's also important that we stop seeing religion used as a kind of cudgel, as if God belonged to a political party. And if he did, I can't imagine it would be the one that sent the current president into the White House.
Uh-huh. It's important that we don't use religion as a cudgel, says the man using religion as a cudgel. For all his faithful fervor, though, Buttigieg is not very interested in certain categories of sin. For example, just last week, authorities raided the home of an Illinois abortion doctor called Ulrich Klopfer, and there they found thousands of preserved aborted fetal remains. Klopfer had plied his trade, it turns out, South Bend, Indiana, the city that St. Pete is the mayor of. But weirdly, so far, Buttigieg has not commented on the incident in any way. Why is that? Philip Wegmann is the White House correspondent over Real Clear Politics. He's been reporting on this story, and he joins us tonight. Philip, thanks so much for coming on. Just to be clear, this is a story that some of our viewers may be kind of familiar with, but describe what we know about this abortion doctor and his relationship to Buttigieg.
What we know is that Ulrich Klopfer was the most prolific abortionist in Indiana for decades. And regardless of your politics or whether you're pro-life or pro-choice or what God you pray to, your heart has to go out to these women because we've discovered that more than 2,000 fetal remains are in this guy's basement right now in Illinois. And so your heart has to go out to these women because women who have had abortions, they're terrified that their terminated pregnancy became this man's trophy. They want answers. They want a federal investigation, and they've said so publicly because the details are too gruesome to ignore unless you're Pete Buttigieg. He has not commented publicly on what was going on in his backyard, and he's offered no guidance to these women who are grieving.
How interesting. I mean, and do you think the reason could be because if he comments on this, it suggests that maybe there's a moral edge or moral problem to abortion?
So I've reached out to his campaign over the weekend repeatedly, and I didn't hear back from them at all about Klopfer, who, again, had been operating for decades in his backyard. And I reached out to his municipal office, and the municipal employee who answered the phone referred me back to Buttigieg's presidential campaign. And again, radio silence. So Buttigieg, he's more than happy to make these statements about being pro-choice, about opposing regulation on abortion clinics. And in fact, he has trumpeted his own defense of an abortion clinic in South Bend that is currently operating without a license. But what he hasn't done is comment on the specifics of this case. It's been complete radio silence.
Interesting. So he stood up on behalf of an abortion clinic operating without a license, to be clear.
He did, to be clear. It's a different one than Klopfer was operating at. But the thing is, this story is not going to go away. Because if you remember, in 2016, President Trump made his pro-life position a promise to evangelicals. He went after Hillary Clinton for her defense of abortion and late-term abortions.
Yes.
So if Pete Buttigieg finds his way on stage against President Trump, or if he finds his way onto the stage against Vice President Pence competing for the vice presidency, he's going to have to answer about why he's been quiet for so long.
Yeah, he doesn't want to upset his donors, I would guess. Phil, thanks so much for that update. I appreciate it.
Thank you, sir.
Good to see you. Mayor Buttigieg may be the most self-promoting